as a whole bunch of muscles piled on top of each other in the sole of the foot. But for convenience, it's described in four layers, starting from the outermost and working our way in, just like you would in an actual dissection. In this video, we are going to dive into each of these layers and take a look at how each of these muscles are attached and how they function. If you want to learn how these muscles help to maintain the arches of the foot, I recommend you watch that video. It'll show up on the top right corner over here. If you want to learn how these muscles help to stabilize the ankle joint, you can watch that video also over here and it'll show up in the top right corner. And let's start with the first layer. This consists of three muscles: the abductor hallucis, the flexor digitorum brevis, and the abductor digiti minimi. The abductor hallucis originates from the medial tuberosity of the calcaneum and flexor retinaculum, and it inserts on the base of the proximal phalanx of the big toe. The flexor digitorum brevis also arises from the medial tubercle of the calcaneum, and this divides into four tendons and inserts into the border of the middle phalanx and the four lateral toes. These tendons are perforated by tendons of the flexor digitorum longus, the adductor digiti minimi. This is the one that flexes the pinky toe. It originates from both the medial and lateral tubercles of the calcaneum and inserts into the base of the proximal phalanx of the fifth toe. The abductor hallucis can flex and abduct the big toe, and this supports the medial longitudinal arch. The flexor digitorum brevis flexes the other four toes. This muscle supports both the medial and lateral longitudinal arches. The abductor digiti minimi can flex and abduct the fifth toe, and it supports the lateral longitudinal arch. Both the abductor hallucis and the flexor digitorum brevis are innervated by the medial plantar nerve. The abductor digiti minimi is innervated by the lateral plantar nerve. This video is sponsored by the Mini Meditech shop. MiniMeditech.com is a website where you can get all your medical school and clinical equipment, such as stethoscopes, stethoscope cases, diagnostic torches, and tendon hammers, all in one place for a reasonable price. I have personally been using their products for about a year now, and I think I can confidently say that you will get a bang for your buck. Just head on over to minimeditech.com and you can start shopping. Here you can browse around and choose the products you need, and you have to choose the color option first, and then click add to cart. Then once you're done with adding all the items to the cart, you can click the top right corner to view cart. Here you can add the coupon code SENPAI in all caps to get an additional 5% discount, and then you can proceed to checkout and add all your delivery contact details here. You have the option to pay with cash on delivery or pay with your credit card, and they will deliver right to your doorstep. Again, make sure you add the coupon code SENPAI. When you dissect and remove these muscles, you reach the second layer, and this has two muscles and two tendons of muscles that originate higher up in the leg. The two muscles are quadratus plantae, also known as the flexor digitorum accessorius, and the forelumbrical muscles. The two tendons are flexor hallucis longus and flexor digitorum longus. The quadratus plantae arises from the medial and lateral sides of the calcaneum, and it gets inserted into the tendons of flexor digitorum longus. This muscle assists the flexor digitorum longus in flexing the lateral four toes, hence why it's called the flexor digitorum accessorius. The flexor digitorum longus tendon lies kinda obliquely in the foot, and the quadratus plantae sort of helps it balance out the forces, otherwise it would be pulling the toes partly to one side. This muscle is innervated by the lateral plantar nerve. The four lumbricals, they are attached to the four tendons of the flexor digitorum longus and distally to the extensor expansion and the basis of the proximal phalanges of the lateral four toes. And this works exactly as the lumbricals in the hand. It keeps the middle phalanx straight while bending the proximal phalanx down. This first lumbrical is innervated by the medial plantar nerve. The rest are innervated by the lateral plantar nerve. And then you have the flexor hallucis longus tendon that crosses underneath the flexor digitorum longus tendon. An important thing to note here is that the lower limbs have flexor digitorum longus and brevis, but the upper limb has flexor digitorum superficialis and profundus. However, both upper and lower limbs, the pollicis or the hallucis muscles, there are two of them, the longus and the brevis. And in both cases, the longus muscle attaches to the base of the distal phalanx and the brevis muscle attaches to the base of the middle phalanx. And you can also note that the distribution of the nerve supply, the medial and lateral plantar nerve, is similar to the distribution of nerve supply by the median nerve and the ulnar nerve in the ventral side of the hand. When we remove this layer, we can reveal the third layer, which has three muscles. the flexor hallucis brevis, the abductor hallucis, and the flexor digiti minimi. Let's first talk about the abductor hallucis. This has two heads, the oblique head and the transverse head. The oblique head arises from the basis of the second, third, and fourth metatarsal bones, and the transverse head arises from the plantar ligaments. These two heads converge together and insert to the lateral side of the base of the proximal phalanx of the big toe. The flexor hallucis brevis originates from the cuboid, lateral cuneiform, and it attaches to the tendon of the tibialis posterior. This muscle divides into two heads towards the insertion and divides into two tendons that insert into the medial and lateral sides of the base of the proximal phalanx of the big toe. And the last muscle of the third layer, the flexor digiti minimi, and as the name explains it, this is the muscle that flexes the small toe. It arises from the base of the fifth metatarsal bone and it gets inserted to the base of the proximal phalanx of the fifth toe on its lateral side. This muscle is innervated by the lateral plantar nerve. The flexor hallucis brevis is innervated by the medial plantar nerve, and abductor hallucis is innervated by the deep branch of the lateral plantar nerve. The fourth layer is similar to the second layer in that it has two tendons and two muscles. The two muscles are the plantar interossei and the dorsal interossei. The two tendons are tibialis posterior and peroneus longus. There are three plantar interossei muscles. They originate from the third, fourth, and fifth metatarsals from their inferior surfaces, and they insert onto the medial side of the base of the proximal phalanges of the third, fourth, and fifth toes respectively. The tibialis posterior originates higher up in the leg, and the tendon reaches the foot and divides into two. The larger superficial division inserts into the plantar surface of the tarsal bones of the foot, mainly onto the tuberosity of the navicular bone and the medial cuneiform bone. The smaller, deeper division inserts onto the medial and lateral cuneiform bones, the cuboid, and the second, third, and fourth metatarsals. And that's it for today. I hope you guys learned something. I have made a quiz for this topic to test your knowledge. You can check the quiz and the web article for this topic. I will link to the link in the description. I have made quizzes and web articles for all of my other educational videos as well, and you can check those out and many more other web articles at my website. Need money, you can just smash the like button and click subscribe and help my channel grow so I can start making money someday. And thanks for watching. Peace.